research called research department, and I'm going to present the paper on safe industry and the concept of knowledge in Islam. In this paper, I have categorized my paper general themes, and the theme of my paper is first theme it is garden. The attempt is to discuss the concept of knowledge with special reference to the Sari Noor after the Zaman Sayyid Musti. And the second theme of my paper is to draw a special attention to the phrase that is knowledge of God, Marifa, we can say Marifatullah. And in this paper, I have also discussed the Ma'arif instructors who make men to know his God, or we can say his leaders, but also sustainer. The framework of my paper is like this. First, I have given the introduction of my paper, then I have discussed knowledge, then the university instructors, Ma'arif, who makes men. These are four instructors: the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Quran, the universe, and the conscience of man. Then concluding remarks. General introduction. In an introduction, I have tried to encapsulate the Badi Zaman Sayyid Musti's magnum opus, Sari Noor, which opened up a new direct way to reality, that's Haqeeqa, and knowledge of God, that is Ma'rifa, which he describes as the highway of the Quran. They are the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam through the legacy of Prophet. Then I have discussed knowledge, epistemological definition of knowledge, Islamic definition of knowledge, Ma'rifa, knowledge of God, and then sources for the knowledge of God that instructors are. What is the epistemological definition of knowledge? What is knowledge? There are many definitions describing the nature of knowledge, but what is of relevance here is the epistemological definition, since it is important to understand what the Islamic epistemological context involves, and implies perhaps its greatest implication lies in its effect upon our vision of reality and truth, and our research methodology, our intellectual scope and practical application in planning for what's called which all bear upon our understanding of education. Knowledge is the awareness of a thing which refers with reference to its reality. Then, Islamic concept of knowledge. The very first revelation of the Quran, based on 5 verses, contains a note of knowledge. Man knew nothing, but now he was blessed with knowledge. He started knowing the reality of things. He was a drop of light from the darkness and deep beach of ignorance. It was the light of awareness that was conferred upon him. Knowledge is in truth a journey towards light and awareness. Knowledge means to be aware, but only that awareness becomes knowledge in the real sense, which brings at a time of great difficulty, in real sense, which brings divine gnosis and nearness to Allah. Then, Ma'rifatullah, knowledge of God. Conception tasawwur dominates the theory of knowledge in Western thought, and is founded on a knowledge, the sources of which is reason or the sense. This first conception was not born of modern age, but is a product of ancient ideal worship. Thus, it was observed that rationalistic tendencies increased to such a degree that they encompassed the field of nature, the manifest world, the supernatural realm, the world of unseen, and the area of morality and values. Likewise, in practical life, the inclination was towards materialism, and the aim of working became pleasure and pursuit interest. In words, Sayyid Musti Rahimahullah writes that the strange world must have someone to regulate it. This strange world must have someone to regulate it, and this orderly country must have a law, and this want to recognize him, who is the person? The purpose of sending of man to this world and the wisdom implicit in it consists of recognizing the creator of all things and believing in him and worshipping him. As Quran says in chapter 52 verse number 56, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I, Allah, created not the jinn and mankind except that they should worship me. The primordial duty of man and the obligation incumbent upon him is to know God and believe in him, to affirm his existence and unity in submission and perfect serenity. For man, who by nature desires permanent life and immortal existence, whose unlimited hopes are matched by boundless applications, any object or accomplishment other than belief in God. Knowledge of God and means for attaining these, which are fundamental and key of eternal life, any such object or accomplishment must be regarded as lowly for man, or even worthless in many cases. In Nursi's thought, Marifat is one of the fruits of belief, Iman, and is considered to be one of the results of being on the straight path of religion. While Marifatullah, knowledge of God, being superiority of God, and struggling with the soul, so that the level of perfection is attained, that the senses and reason could not attain on their own. It is because of this that from beginning to the end, Salim speaks of knowledge of God, for which the phrase recognizing the God is also used. There is a phrase, some say it is Hadith, some say it is quote of the Sultan, some say it is quote of the Ali of the Lamb. But our effort is here, Dr. Amit Amara is here. I apologize for this. Man arafana suhu fakat arafana prabhu. One who knows himself knows God. The true affirmation of divine unity, which through seeing on everything the stamp of his power, the seal of his dominarity, and the inscription of his pen, is to open a window directly on his light from everything and to confirm and believe with almost the certainty and seeing that everything emerges from the hand of his power, and that in no way has he any partner or assistance in his Godhead or in his dominionality or in his sovereignty. And thus to attain the sort of perpetual awareness of the divine presence. It is because of this that from beginning to end, Risale-Nur speaks of knowledge of God, for which the phrase recognizing the God, as our Prophet told, is also used. It shows us the way that will take us to the knowledge of God. Then, I will talk about the sources to knowledge of God. In the light of Salimun, there are numerous instructors, Ma'arif, which guides man to carry out his duty of worship and make known to man his sustainer of the Prophet Muhammad, the Quran, the universe, and the conscience of man. I have elaborated the four instructors as, first I have given a brief reading of the Prophet Muhammad as an instructor, which leads man to be sustainer. The first of the universal instructors who described our sustainer to us and acquaints us with him is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the reason for the world's creation. It is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who provides convincing answers accepted to all uncorrupted minds. He is an articulate guru. We should listen to him, for what he says solves the riddles of the universe and makes known to us our sustainer. For he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam uncovered the perfections of the universe and set forth the purpose of creation of the beings. He was addressed by all things in many appropriate to the aim of their creation and showed it to us. He then proclaims that universal and absolute mercy with all his acts and states. They saw the new people us to listen to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's words as words that deliver the universe from meaninglessness. Gain importance for it and impart existence and life to things and illuminate them. The God's messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam becomes a teacher in man's eyes, a teacher of ma'rifah, knowledge. At the heart of everything he teaches is the affirmation of the divine unity. There is the cognition of one creator which directs us to worship him alone. The duty of people of consciousness and intelligence in this world, everything of which our sustainer created through our art and purpose, is to ponder over his duties reflected in the art and proclaim them wonderingly. It was Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who performed this duty, which is described in this Risale-e-Noor as the basis of worship. Most perfectly in this respect, all the words and acts of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam are seen in the Risale-e-Noor as words and acts making known our sustainer and his announcer and the chief of the spheres of worship. Then Quran. The Quran is another universal instructor, all of which have great importance and are inseparable from one another. Quran, being the guide of the Risale-e-Noor, holds an endless importance. The Risale-e-Noor's way may be summarized demonstrating the Quran's truth under the guidance of the Quran, and from this point of view, its definition of the Quran is extremely meaningful. The Quran, which comes from God's infinite knowledge, is a translation of the universe, which appears as a vast book. All the things in the vast universe are signs of creation, a God of all things. The Quran is a revealed scripture which contains in summary the books of all the prophets, whose times were all different, the writings of all the saints, whose paths are all different, and the works of all the purified scholars, whose ways are all different. The Quran was when the Arab writers, politicians of Arab, called that this Quran is not the book revealed, the revealed book.
Don't explain orally. Read your paper. They were down taking. Explaining again and reading also. So time become double.
I will consign your paper. Only 15 minutes just give you.
Read your paper.
Why couldn't he write in Manasana Athena? Kalu Bisurat in Misri, Kalu Hadakumu in Lakim Kuntu Swati. And if we are in doubt, and to what we have revealed from time to time to our servant, then produce a surah like their aunt and call your witness on the helpers if they are not in. Besides Allah, if your doubts are removed. Then I will directly come to the book of your dreamer. The first and most direct and shortest way leading to knowledge of God, the highest point of perfection man can reach, is the way of the Quran. In fact, the Quran teaches how we address ourselves to other three ways. For instance, with many of its verses, the Quran invites man to consider how beings are created. It makes known the creator of the heavens and the earth and all they contain as an all-glorious and possessing absolute knowledge, absolute power and absolute will. It points out that nothing can be a partner to God. The Risale-e-Noor describes the universe as a vast book or a vast human being. Each word of this book and each letter is created so miraculously that infinite power sufficient to create the whole universe is necessary. In order to create even the minutest particle in exactly the right place. While presenting the universe as a vast universe evidence for divine unity, the all-wise Quran most frequently uses evidence that the mass of people will understand easily. Examples of this are the earth, sky, stars, moon, rain, water, clouds, etc. The Risale-e-Noor has also adopted this method and style in accordance with the Quranic approach, which may be summarized as demonstrating divine oneness with divine unity. It shows that all these minute particles to the stars are brilliant proofs of the existence of the necessarily existent one, who possesses absolute power. Then the conscience of man. The fourth instructor describing our sustainer to us and making him known is man's conscience, which has been deposited in his self as a trust. Man is encompassed the whole universe. They exceed it. Even man has intense need for life after death, and all his senses want immortality and eternity. However, on his own, he does not have the power to meet any of these needs, and such power is not to be found in anything else. Since everything is created like himself, man has been decked out with extremely fine senses, and all the time feels the need to find a point of support in the face of his obvious impotence. He sees, in fact, that his life, youth, senses, the food which he enjoys eating, his clothes, in brief, all the bounties bestowed on him are day by day being lost to him. That they are leaving him. He can find no power in himself to prevent their departure. He longs for his youth not to depart for those he loves, not to abandon him, but he can do nothing apart from desiring these things. In fact, in face of this helplessness, his conscience hopes for a point from which it can seek help, a support for which it can find discipline. The conscience performs a function of great importance in making known our sustainer. In the Risale-i-Noor, it is described as a place of transit where the world of the unseen and the manifest world came together, and where thoughts and aspirations from those two worlds meet. The Risale-i-Noor likens the conscience to the laws of nature. That is, the essential nature of things does not lie. When a handful of water freezes, the inclination to expand in its nature necessitates that it takes up more space. It expands even if it is in an iron container, and it simplifies the iron. Strong iron cannot prevent what the water's nature necessitates. Inclination such as this are the appearances and manifestations of the commands related to the creation which God has laid down with his will. Then I will conclude my paper. This general conclusion shows that the Quran and Sunnah give importance to knowledge, as knowledge without distinguishing between different sorts of knowledge. However, whether science or philosophy or technological knowledge, if it has not been modified by revolution, it means it has not risen to the level of Quranic enlightenment knowledge. Enlightenment knowledge is knowledge which revolution has infused belief, and in the Islamic framework is a level which all sorts of knowledge have reached. The opposite of this knowledge is ignorance. However, knowledgeable person, a person is, and of whatever knowledge he is informed to the very highest degree. If he does not reach his level of knowledge, his knowledge is the equivalent of ignorance and harm to mankind. That is to say, knowledge that is not enlightened by evolution causes harm to people rather than benefit. Thank you.